Hi and welcome back to Cheeky Crypto. In today's video, we're going to be diving down into the world of MultiVAC, specifically taking a look at the price action of MTV. As we get into this, if you do find it useful and informative, hit the like button. I really do appreciate that. If you happen to be new to the channel, why not go ahead and subscribe, tap the bell, select all notifications, and in doing so, you will be kept up to date with everything that we do here at Cheeky Crypto. Right, with all that said, done, and out of the way, let's get into it. Okay guys, so we're just on the weekly chart here. As we can see, good growth has occurred with MultiVAC and MTV. And I think it's just important that we kind of acknowledge the kind of growth that we've already had and you know, where we see things kind of going, right? So obviously we had the new all-time high. So if we actually take a look at this from a bull run perspective, really kind of starting out back in March of 2020 and through to the all-time high that we've actually achieved, we're talking about 18,579% in gains. That's the same kind of gains that we've seen with VeChain and Harmony One, right? So getting in super early to these projects is absolutely key. Now, I think for most people who were probably getting in, you know, during this year, and specifically the pullback that we've actually had seen in terms of, you know, from May downwards, you know, those are still some fantastic gains that have been made, right? So even if we were to take this on a conservative low area that we had in July, for example, they've already seen 945% in gains. Even if you're a late adopter, let's say hypothetically, you're able to pick up a bag in October, then actually, you know, you're still 100% in gains from that potential as well. So it's fantastic to see this project really take in some interesting kind of levels, really grow nicely to the upside. Now, obviously with the launch of their NFT platform, we're starting to see some interesting transactions kind of occur and a bit more, you know, kind of progress with MTV and MultiVAC as a whole, right? Smart contracts are next on the list and definitely seem to be hitting things as they kind of have been promising, which is fantastic to see. Obviously, as MultiVAC starts to heat up a bit more, we are going to start seeing some interesting kind of price discovery, at least I do believe. I think there's a few key things we obviously have to analyze and have to understand when it comes to MultiVAC. One is it's incredibly new. The mainnet only really just went live. Obviously, the NFT platform has gone live. I think it was earlier this week or back end of last week. And you know, on the face of all of these things, smart contracts are next on the list. So I think, you know, with some interesting kind of price discovery that we've seen so far, I think there's going to be a hell of a lot more still to come, specifically as we start to talk about more marketing aspects and, of course, any potential new, you know, exchanges actually listing the, you know, listing the actual MTV token, right? Because as a result of that, we're going to start seeing a significant demand increase for MultiVAC. That obviously coupled up with the staking side of things and the fact that there's such a huge amount of supply actually already staked, it is going to end up with an interesting kind of place where, you know, there's a squeeze on the supply, we have the demand coming in, that we could start to see some interesting price discovery and price spikes with MTV. Now, obviously, I have a pretty good position in MTV. Chris has a pretty good position. And if we were to ever sell, we'll let you know, as it happens. So we're not going to just dump a bag on you guys or anything like that. And I think for the most part, many MTV holders are in a very similar boat. We believe in the technology. We believe this basically really growing quite nicely, right? And I know, you know, there's a lot of smart contract platforms out there and et cetera, et cetera, you know, ETH 2.0, you know, but there's platforms like specifically ETH where you have to wait for a while to actually see it get launched. Well, here's a platform that's doing multi-dimensional sharding and fantastic tech behind the system. You know, it could actually start to be, you know, a little bit better maybe. And we'll have to see how things evolve over time with the smart contracts and the use cases and potential dApps that get built on the system. But it's definitely placed quite well, I think, in the world of crypto. And I do anticipate this one actually growing up quite nicely to be a pretty big player in the space in the coming years. So happy to kind of be in here nice and early, get it staked, and of course, earn a nice passive income on their MTV. Okay, so when it comes to price discovery, there's a few things we have to consider, right? First of all, 9.2 cent is the fib from the previous all-time high down to bear market low. Okay, that's 9.2 cent. We have a 7.2 cent area. This is based on the performance here of the high that we had. I think it was up in April and the low that we had down in May. Okay, take that into consideration. That's 7.2. We can, of course, use a trend-based fib. We can take the low area from down here, the high area that we had, you know, up in April, the low area of May. And again, This actually then shows us the trends and how that's kind of playing out to 7.9. Okay, so nothing too major, nothing too crazy at this point, all within the realm of possibility. But when we start thinking about, you know, potential for MultiVAC, where could it actually go when we get exchange listings, we get smart contracts, we start to get a lot more kind of drive for or demand for the actual token MTV, where does it go? Well, you know, we've speculated quite a bit about 30 cent. I think that's something that is possible under the right circumstances. I don't think a dollar is something that we can have in this particular cycle. I'd love to be wrong on that, but I don't think it's something that we'll actually see. But, you know, I think it's possible that we could see 30 cent under the right conditions, i.e. we have great marketing, we've had you know, good exchange listings, and there's a good amount of demand and hype for what is potentially, you know, ETH 2.0 just now, right? And I think that's going to be an interesting time. That could lead to 1,200% in gains, right? But obviously, it's very speculative. It requires if this and if that, right? It's definitely outside of the data. It's not something that we can see from a technical point of view. It's something that we have to believe in from a fundamental perspective, okay? So it's on the charts here with these kind of theoretical kind of pushes for growth, right? I think personally we'll end up at 10 cent if nothing fundamentally happens around that marketing or those exchange listings, okay? And 10 cent from where we are right now is a good 5x, right? It's a good comfortable place to be. So again, in line pretty much with the expectation of the crypto market in this last leg of the bull run, most coins are kind of averaging out around the 5x position, okay? And I think that's the expectation that many people should be having, unless something amazing happens in the space that we can see some fundamental shifts that change the technical data. Okay, so I just wanted to kind of cover that off. 30 cent is something that we do want to see, but it does have a lot of ifs and a lot of buts about it. Okay, so from a technical point of view, it's not there. But you know, where we think it could potentially be going, yeah, that's a possibility, as is most things in the space. That being said, it's not supported just yet by technical data. Okay, so let's jump down into our daily, right? Because this is where we actually start to see some of the most recent price action and price moves. Now, we've been tracking buy zones for members for quite some time. Obviously, down here was a fantastic buying opportunity. We had that massive surge to the upside, which was great. Obviously, this actually posts an interesting area from additional buy zones, right? Again, an opportunity was had here. And obviously, the latest one right in this area, the 618, 702, 786 area, finding this trend here, finding the downtrend, right? We're tracking this triangular wedge. We've had the breakout of the triangular wedge. We pushed up to new all-time highs and we slipped back a little bit again, just naturally taking some profits from the space and you know, looking to continue the growth overall. Okay, so it's important that we acknowledge that we are heavily oversold on our daily chart, right down here on our stochastic RSI. Obviously, the stochastic is more sensitive to price movements than the RSI, the regular relative strength index. I can actually throw that on for you so you can see where that sits. It's actually up here in a mid-range point, okay? And this one's slower. This one's for trends, ideally, right? So when you actually start seeing a trend go, here you can see a trend. Here you can see a trend forming to the downside right here before we had that break to the upside. And obviously right now we actually just pulled right back down into this lower area, an area that we have seen many times before. So from an RSI, this is great, but personally I prefer, when it comes to talking about the smaller time frames, looking at that stochastic RSI, because it's more sensitive to price. It allows us to see whether or not we're going to be pushing up one particular day or down the next particular day. Okay. Obviously, you cannot use a stochastic RSI on its own. You must use a stochastic RSI in conjunction with resistance, support lines, trend lines, and other patterns as well. Okay, because this really helps you hone in on exactly what is going on. For example, you can be oversold for a very long time and overbought for a very long time on the stochastic RSI, and it all depends on where you sit with other patterns, other trends, etc., in the actual data. Okay, so it's good to know that we're oversold, and the question then becomes, have we found a good level of support to bounce from and take this up into and out of this area here, up into the overbought zone? So on the daily chart, everything's looking pretty good to be down in this lower area with plenty of room to grow to the upside. Okay, at this point, we're going to jump over to the evide.io dashboard. If you're not familiar, links in the description down below. And they use artificial intelligence machine learning to help us understand the underlying value of cryptocurrencies. It's completely free to use. If you're not already signed up, guys, check it out. I don't think you're going to be disappointed. Now, for MultiVAC here, we can see that we've got the green arrows, which means we've gone up a rating, right? So we were B1, we've now gone up to an A3 rating. This is actually a pretty bullish signal that could basically start to see us with some improvement in the price action of MTV. After consolidating down, getting a nice accumulation going, we can now start to see some potential pushed back to the upside. Again, that's coupled with the fact that we're oversold on our daily chart. Now, from that data, we can actually go down into some more detail. We have a fear and greed index that's specific to MultiVAC, and this is a C1 rating. So there's a lot of fear still in the market for MTV, but we've spiked up massively, right? We can see this green line. It is moving up quite nicely in the crypto fear and greed index. So overall, this is actually looking pretty good and pretty interesting. The overall market fear and greed index is also right up here as well, actually in a pretty neutral to greedy position. So we have some growth to come in and to see how this actually now starts to form out. Now, the Sharpe ratio is an A2. This is actually indicating to us that the rewards outweigh the risks, and the fact that matter, we might want to have some exposure to MTV. We can only see that actually we've dropped below the 50-day average on one particular day, the 28th of September. All the other times up here, we've seen way above that 50-day average, saying that exposure to MTV isn't a bad idea. Now, I'm not offering financial advice. Chris doesn't offer financial advice. Evide.io are not giving you financial advice or indicators. What they're telling is actually giving you the tools to make your own decisions. So obviously, with a fear and greed index that's where it is right now, with a little bit of fear in there and a Sharpe ratio that's saying you might want to buy it up, it's a pretty interesting piece of information. As we come down, we have an AMIHAD ratio that's A2, basically indicating that liquidity is fine. Buying and selling MTV is actually pretty fluid. We have a moving averages here for A2 rating, 50, 10, 50, and 100-day moving averages are looking pretty good as well. No problem with those. The profitability right up there is an A1 rating. As I said, guys, it's on the same kind of league as VeChain and Harmony One in terms of the profitability that it's driven out so far. So looking very, very healthy and very, very good, and good to see that that has gone up a rating. When we come back into our data, we can jump down into our hourly view. From our hourly view, we can actually take a look at those candles and see exactly what's been going on most recently. We can see that we have actually pulled back quite significantly, retesting our trend line to the downside. Okay, so where we broke out, we pulled pretty much all the way back down, and now we're starting to spike back up again. And obviously, we can see if we actually drill into this in a little bit more detail, we're starting to move back up. But obviously, we are moving up quite nicely here, and the stochastic RSI is about midway through, still plenty of room to grow. But we should be aware that we are tracking here, you know, within a couple of areas of interest, right? First of all, 2.1 and 2.4 cents. These are areas that we've been kind of stuck into for a while. Although we have kind of bounced out a little bit, these are the areas that we kind of always seem to be gravitating towards. I think ultimately we are getting ready for a big move to the upside, but there's no clear patterns here forming right now to say that that is definitely something that we're likely to see. I think we have to be aware that we could actually be starting to form an inverse head and shoulders. And again, I'll just quickly throw this on here and we'll confirm it at a later stage. Let me find. So we grab that head and shoulder pattern, for example, and we can see that we have this head and shoulders, inverse head and shoulders, I should say, just forming out here. Now, I'm not going to draw it bang onto the actual candles. I'll try to make it as neat an example as I can. But we could basically see this potentially forming out with a head and shoulder pattern like this, right? And this would basically allow us to kind of pull that up there. For example, this would basically indicate that we have a huge surge to the upside, potentially taking out that 3 cent area. We are looking to track to the upside overall. I do prefer to try to draw out, you know, some triangles if I can, and to see if there's anything in there, but we're too soon in this particular pattern to see whether or not that's something that is likely to occur. I do think that we are likely to see a break to the upside as soon as the market starts to heat up again, and I do anticipate that is something that we could potentially see within the next week or so, depending on what Bitcoin does. Obviously, Bitcoin's on a bit of a pullback this particular weekend, but after that, I do anticipate Bitcoin doing some pretty good moves next week, and I think it's potentially see some new all-time highs actually forming out for BTC. So if that happens, do expect things like MTV to also get a good surge to the upside. Our main target that we're really talking about is 3 cents. We want to get that one taken out before we actually start to take out the additional areas such as 4.5 and 6.2. And so all eyes really are on the next few days when it comes to MultiVAC, seeing what happens here. But we are expecting a bit of a surge to the upside in the coming week alongside things like Bitcoin. Guys, I'm going to leave the video there. If you have found it useful and informative, hit the like button. I really do appreciate that. If you happen to be new to the channel, why not go ahead and subscribe, tap the bell, select all notifications, and in doing so, you will be kept up to date with absolutely everything that we do here at Cheeky Crypto. With this said, done, and out of the way, I hope everyone has a fantastic day, and I'll catch you all in the next one.